गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द फोटोसिंथेसिस। व्हाट इज फोटोसिंथेसिस? फोटोसिंथेसिस इट इज द प्रोसेस इन विच द सोलर एनर्जी ट्रैप्ड इज एब्सॉर्ब बाय द क्लोरोफिल एंड इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू द कार्बोहाइड्रेट। नाउ लेट्स सी द रिएक्शन। इन दिस द कार्बन ऑक्साइड इट इज टेकन अप बाय द प्लांट्स, दैट इज 6 CO2 प्लस 6H2O. Here it is in presence of chlorophyll and sunlight. It produces the carbohydrate. Carbohydrate it is in the form of glucose. Glucose it is what? It is the sugar. It is the form of sugar, just like the lactose, sucrose. In the same way, glucose is there. So it forms C6H12O6. Plus, at the same time, it also releases some oxygen. It is in presence of air. It goes to the upside because oxygen is lighter than others. So, oxygen is a side product. Here we can say that this carbon dioxide plus water. And here it is the glucose, oxygen. Now see here what happens. This carbon dioxide, it broken down, it splits into what? Into the carbohydrate, into the glucose. In the same way, water is split up into the oxygen and hydrogen. So in this way, this chemical reaction takes place. This solar energy is trapped by the plant and it convert into the carbohydrate, that is the glucose. Now let's see what happens actually in this photosynthesis. See, you can see here, it is the diagrammatic representation. It is the transverse section of leaf. So when we are taking the transverse section of leaf, we just seen like this. So here, this layer, it is the cuticle. This layer, it is called as the epidermis. Cuticle, it is the waxy layer. And it provides to get more evaporation from the plant, from the leaves, and it also provides from the mechanical damages. Below that, exactly below the cuticle, what it is present, that is the epidermis. Epidermis, it means the outer layer, which is protective in nature. Now see, here some gaps are there, and below that, it is this epidermal layer is followed by such cells are present there. These are the parenchymatous cells, and which contains these green colored pigments. These green colored pigments are present over there, and these green colored pigments, these are nothing but the chloroplasts. Okay, now what is the function of this chloroplast? This chloroplast contains the pigments, the small green colored pigments in them, which is responsible for the photosynthesis. And these chlorophyll only trap. This chlorophyll absorbs the solar energy, the light energy from the sun, and then it converts into the carbohydrates. So there are, we can see that the lot of such green pigments are there. And here in between there some gaps are present. You can see here the gaps are present. These gaps are called as the air gaps. Okay. These air gaps, these are present here, these are loosely arranged cells are present, and in between that the transaction of air takes place. Now see, after these layers, after 2-3 layers of these cells, there forms the another layer which is called as the lower epidermis. Lower epidermis. Now what happens? This lower epidermis, it is present on the ventral surface of the leaf, and on the dorsal surface of leaf this upper epidermis is present. When we see in this line of epidermis, we see in some structures here. Okay, if you see in this one, these structure, these are called as the guard cells. Okay, now you can see that these guard cells, these are the guarding cells, these are the protective cells. To whom it guards? To the stomata. Okay, stomata are present over here, and through these stomata the air is passes in, and through these air gaps, this air passes, this CO2 passes and absorbed up by the cells, and then again it convert into the carbohydrates. The same thing it happens continuously, but it is not necessary that immediately it happens after the absorption of CO2. Okay, so for that purpose, sometimes, for example, in the desert plants, what happens in case of the desert plants? In desert plants, the CO2 is being absorbed during the night time, and when it gets activated, so what we see here, these lower epidermis, it consists of these stomata, and these stomata consist of the two guard cells which are present on the side beneath. From this, the air, it goes inside, it converts the solar energy into the chemical energy and produces the glucose. Now see, as I told you, like in the desert plants, they absorb the CO2 from the atmosphere, and during the daytime they activate the chlorophyll pigment, they utilize this to produce the glucose. And in this way, this photosynthetic activity, it is takes place in the autotrophic plants or in the autotrophs. And that's why this photosynthetic activity, it is shown by the phototrophs only, the grasses, the blue-green algae, the cyanobacteria, all these having this photosynthetic activity. They shows photosynthetic activity and they converts these water and carbon dioxide into the glucose, and later on it stores in the form of starch in various parts of the plant parts. I hope guys you get this photosynthesis and the reaction very well. In the next video I will tell you about the difference.